This is a demonstration video on naming cells and managing named cells in Microsoft Excel version 2010. As you can see by my spreadsheet, there are two parts. Part 1 has a smaller list of data than Part 2, and this is because there are two primary ways to change the names of cells. The first way is to change the name manually by typing the new name in the name box at the top. This cell B8 corresponds to the rain in inches for the month of January. So we're going to change the name up here to JAN, January. And now this cell has the name of January. You can go through and change that for every single cell. This can get tedious, but it does make sure that you know exactly what is named each name. However, if you were to make a mistake, and for example, instead of selecting the rain for June, you were to change the name of the month to June. If you go and try and change the name of the rain, it won't let you. It'll just take you back to that original cell that already has the name J-U-N. So what you can do to remove the name from this cell and put it on this cell is you go to Formulas and Name Manager. This brings up a box that has a list of all the names that have been used in this spreadsheet. Here you can see there's April, February, January, June, March, and May. And June is the one we want to change. Two ways to do this is, one, we can delete it and rename the new cell, or we can edit it and change the A to B. And this is saying that for the spreadsheet named rain, which is the spreadsheet we're on, to always do cell B13. You select OK and close it. B13 now has the name of June. And you can continue on and changing the names of each of these manually. Here we have a list of cities and its corresponding annual precipitation. I'm going to select just the city name and the precipitation, and do Control Shift down to highlight the entire selection. If I go here and click Create from Selection, I want to change the name in the right column to what is listed in the left column. So create names from values in the left column. Select OK. If I go here, this cell has the name of Birmingham, Mobile, Montgomery, Anchorage. And the cities that have spaces in their names, that space is replaced with an underscore. There are other ways to define the names. Instead of just selecting the cell and then changing the name here, you can also change the name using Define Name. And you can type the name. I'm going to use December. And I want this to refer to, instead of F18, which is the cell here, I want it to refer to B19. And I can do that by either changing this to B19 or by deleting that and pressing this button and selecting the cell. Press Enter and OK. This cell has now been named December, D-E-C. Use in Formula is the last thing in this Defined Name section, is where you can go through this entire list of names and select one to be used in a formula on your spreadsheet.